before I get demonetized from Luke Combs playing. We got the lip here about to go on. I just pulled the skirts and the rear spat things out into the garage. We're gonna do those first, not last. The bumper's gotta come off for that. So we have this stuff to put on. This should be pretty easy. I think there's just three or four pieces of hardware to go in for these. And then all of these are, the skirts are just, whatchamacallit, self-tappers. So these should be pretty simple, quote unquote. And well, after that, the bumper's gotta come off, but
the car's gonna look so much more complete once we got a lip on it.
Well, the instructions are fairly simple. Fit it, drill it, you're done. And they actually show a golf bumper, so this will be interesting. I haven't even set these up to the car yet, so let's go and check that out. I'm not sure which side goes where. Sorry about the mower, my neighbor's outside mowing. Yeah, I just want to fill this area up a little bit more, so these should probably go. Oh yeah, that'll fit perfect. Look at that. Nice. Okay, I see you, Maxton. I just don't know exactly how, what angle, but yeah, if we do it too far, maybe it is this side that goes over here. No, that doesn't fit right. I'll have to do some playing around, line it up. All right, so we got the side skirt lined up. We're gonna come back to the rear things after this. So
they line up perfectly. They look great. I just have the jack under there. My dad's about to come out and help, so you guys get to see a little bit of him. This is off a little bit. I need to push it back, but this is gonna look real good on here.
And it's all self-tappers, so it's pretty simple. We just gotta hold it in place while we do it. The instructions are awful for this, honestly. And it came with these things. I have no idea. Maybe these are supposed to cover the holes for this, but it wouldn't even, there's not even enough to do that. So I don't know what's going on there. We're just gonna zip them in and hope it holds. So we had to take a break for a little bit, go look at some houses. If you guys watched the last video, we did not, we didn't even wind up putting an offer in on my house at the lift. It was just too far out of the norm drive and life. Anyway, had to go out and get a Dremel, and I got a sprayer. My car is still unlocked. I got a sprayer here so I can spray my tires at autocross. We're going autocross tomorrow, so we can cool the tires down. Excuse me. And spray it on like the radiator and intercooler and stuff to help. Anyway, so we got this skirt on. I don't know if I like the position I have it in, because it's almost, I mean, it's not almost, it is literally flush, which I do like the way it looks. But I might test on the other side, maybe stick it out a little bit further.
Is this one, because like it kind of like comes out on its own, but I might just bring it out about that much for the whole thing and have to stick out just that much further. I'm not sure, we'll see. But right now what we're dealing with, so we got this one, we didn't take the coating off of it yet, that's why it looks rough, but it fits great. I lined it up, it fits great up until here, and then here's where we have our problem. There's this gap here where you can see through. Sorry guys, it's super bright, so I can't really see the camera screen, but you can see through here, and then it comes through here. So just got a Dremel, because mine went missing, and we're gonna try and chop this up to make it sit flush right up against here, and then I don't know, it's gonna be tough. It's gonna be a tough cut, honestly, to get this just right, but we're gonna do our best. Y'all, this has been a whole process of learning, but we got some cut now with the Dremel, hopefully at the proper angle. Ignore this, you won't see it, but dad's help, we got these. Let's see. Trying to get the angle right on the tip is just really hard to match it up onto this. So now it's pretty, what the hell? Should be something like that. Now I used to have a gap, it was like this. It looked really gross. So we're getting closer to where we want it. It's hard to do with one hand. All right, ladies and gents, this is the look. been a process. There is still a small gap here. What I think I'm gonna do is fill that with, what's it called? Black sealant, silicone.
No way from afar, you at least can't see the crack.
I think I can get it to look pretty dang good. I'm not a body guy. And like I said, this wasn't made for this, especially to work with the rigger diffuser, Maxton splats or whatever they call it. So I think it looks really good. Maybe this side does stick out a little less than this side, but maybe I'll fix it. Either way, barely hit it. Put the car on the ground. It looks good.
Especially this angle is what I felt it was lacking a lot along the side of the bumper. So now we'll get this other skirt on. I'm gonna bring it out a little bit further than this side because I don't really know what I'm gonna like. I like this because it's subtle, but at the same time I feel like it might need to come out a little bit, since now that that's on, I feel like this should be out just as much, you know?
I don't know, just as
so
much.
We might just bring this side back out. We'll test it on the other side, find out what we like, and then we can finally move on to the best part. There we go. Oh, what up, people?
We're down here struggling.
But we decided to do it further out like you're actually supposed to do after some research, so. Doing that in, and it's all self-tappers, so it's super easy. But the holes they provide don't actually go to anything. So you gotta go a little bit forward of the holes for it to actually hold on to something. But so far so great, not terrible. I forgot to pull the coating off of it, but we'll get there. Well, now we're back on the other side, bringing it out some so it actually matches. I really didn't like the way it looked poking out a little bit, like it's actually supposed to be, until we got the rear things on. Then it made sense. It kind of flowed better. Can't say I'm a fan of these self-tappers.
Golly. All right. They are on now. Hopefully this looks decent on camera. It's kind of in the shade. You can kind of see here where I scratched it up. I'm gonna try and fix that up now, but looks really good. I like the way that looks, especially with the rear things. That looks really good.
All right, guys, we are back a couple days later after autocross. I kind of ran out of time. It was hot and miserable after getting all the rest of the stuff done, but it's on there. It looks great.
It held up through the racing and driving through the grass and dirt and stuff, so pretty happy with it. Other than, like, kind of from a distance, you can see the hardware when you walk up to the car. So I don't know what I might have to, like, spray them black or something, or just deal with it. I don't know. That's the only thing I don't like so far. But of course, now we're moving on to the bumper.
I just taped up the lights a little bit just to hopefully avoid some scratching. I'm hoping it's like every other MQB car and we just do all the T25s under and around the bumper, and it looks up here like we just got some pop clips, and then we'll have to deal with this and then the washer fluid. I'm hoping we can just disconnect it from the washer fluid pump, which actually might be on this side on this car. Yeah, it looks like the reservoir goes down there somewhere. And then we have the sensors for ACC and the parking sensor. So shouldn't be too terrible. Might make a little bit of a mess with the washer fluid, but should be all right.
All right, guys, so the first steps I did was pull these clips out. They are the typical annoying clips that everybody hates.
I suggest getting a tool for it, like I do. One of these, looks like easy. And then this whole kind of cover gets loose, and I was like, well, how the hell do you get it around the latch?
Well, you turn the latch and you get a pick in there, and this little guy comes out, which locks it into place, and it's keyed. So you get a couple flat spots, they match up, boom.
That's that. So far, so good. This one actually might be easier than my Golf to do.
Yeah, and then the latch stays on the core support. It looks like we got some T30s here for the bumper. Not bad. Oh, look at all that space in there. There's so much space.
Huh. All right, fellas, we're over here on the side. We had 1, 2, 3, 4 T25s, if you guys can see those. And then there's one T30 straight up in there. I kind of tucked this back, pulled this out of the fender liner. And then there is a sensor right there for the parking sensor, but I don't think you have to unplug it right now, because the way the wiring goes that way, I think they all might tie together and then have one plug that goes to the body, which would make life easy. And then you have, you can see the pump here. I think we'll be able to just disconnect it from right here and put a plug on the pump so it doesn't leak all over the place. But we'll see. I'm not going to do that yet. All right, guys, little update here. So I'm showing you guys through the bumper. When you look in, so you got the one that's vertical, and you want to get this one right here. It'll be a T25. It goes in right there. I got that stuck. As you can see, all the sensors stay on the bumper, and there'll be one. There's one central point where it goes to the body, and it's right there. That connector right here. And then I also had to disconnect the washer fluid, like I said, right there at the pump. I put a little cap on that and a cap in the other side so it doesn't spill a whole lot. Now we'll disconnect this, and I believe that should be the only thing. Yeah, that'll be the only thing. So it just ain't a bad job at all. Here, see this guy right here?
Yeah.
This, not the plastic, but this. This line goes up right here, and it plugs right here into the headlight. I don't know.
Some kind of sensor.
I think it's for like moisture, like condensation maybe. That's really interesting. I wonder if the Mark 8s have something like that.
Where does it?
Look at all this room for activity.
Go into a hole or something down here?
Nope. Something. This is just soft stuff. So this is just to help direct air, keep air going in here instead of coming out the sides.
Nice black condenser. Look at all this junk down in there. To clean that out. There's plenty of room for activity, so I can't wait to get the do 88. So yeah, this core support's definitely way different than the Mark 7. Same with this. Sensor's in a little different spot. I mean, all in all, it looks to be about the same process too. And so you still got those stupid clips here. It doesn't look like you can adjust the, because on the old core support you had two T20 or two T30s and you could adjust the angle of the core support, but it doesn't look like that's there. Huh. My little, well, there's a cigarette button there and some. All right, let's clean that shit up. All right, guys. Well, all in all, that was a pretty simple job. I still need to clean it out, but I just took the bumper inside, lined up the lip, brought in the drill and stuff. We got it lined up. Hopefully, I mean, there's like some small air gap. Like once you push it down, it looks like there's a small gap right in here on both sides, but maybe once it's all pressed down across the board, it'll clear it up. So this is our little setup. Say hi, Ben. Say hi, Mom.
Hi.
Getting things done. Boys. All right, boys. So you guys don't make the same mistake as me. I went ahead and drilled the first hole, and it wasn't coming through the other side, which, now you can obviously see why. This plate here, you got to pop out all these clips, and then you have enough. Because once you drilled through this, the screws weren't long enough.
They wouldn't go through, and I was like, okay, well, I'll drill the hole bigger and use some taller ones, and those still wouldn't go through. And then we gathered a couple more brain cells together and decided, hey, well, let's pop this off, and
look, now there's plenty of room. So, and with doing it that way, this plastic piece will cover the hardware on the other side of this bumper. Otherwise, if you were doing it the other way, when this was up, when you were looking through the bumper, you would have saw all the hardware holding the lip on. So this works. Guys, all right, guys, after going back and forth 100 times, when you put this stuff together, make sure you put the small headed ends on here, because it's going to hit this stuff and this isn't going to clip back down on there. So I just spent a bunch of time. I cut all the extra threads off because it was hitting. Then I realized it was still too long. I was like, why didn't I just put
the other head on this side because I'm a dummy. So now that these are all kind of flush, this piece will slide right on. Then you put the bumper back on, you're good to go. I'll
show you guys the finished clip once we're done.
You got places where the bumper slides onto here and here, and where
everything went together nice and smooth once we figured out what we were doing. It's gorgeous. I love it.
The car feels complete now with the skirts and the rear drums.
I look really good.
I have to wash the car up. She's filthy. I'm gonna wash it up tonight, snag some pictures, and I'll throw those in the end here, but
man, I love that. Especially like right over here, the side parts are like my favorite.
That looks great.
Shout out to my dad for giving a nice helping hand. It was fun.
Was.
The next day, she's all washed up and so pretty. The car looks so good. I wanna give a huge shout out to Sean and It's Not Stock for adding Maxton to the site. I know me and a couple others were bugging him to get him on there because we wanted to give him the business. And now I got on there, I was one of the first people to order this shit, and I am so glad I did. Also shout out to Maxton for making a very pretty looking product. But on that note, what you guys should know is the material that the front splitter is made out of is like a shattering type of plastic. Like if you were to throw a rock hard enough at it, it would probably shatter. Just keep that in mind, but it does look really pretty. Now if you get the material that the side skirts are made out of, you could like bend that and whack it against, I don't know, someone's head, and it wouldn't break, go back to its shape. It's just that the type of material. But
let's give her a good look here.
Beautiful. I love it.
Yeah, this is like a different type of material. This is like we bent and stuff.
So good.
I love it.
Back end looks complete now.
It just looks great.
I'm so happy with the way the car looks. Beautiful. All right, guys, that's all I got. Next video after this will be autocross with my dad. And we were so caught up in the day, we didn't get any pictures. I didn't get a single picture of the car or us together, which I'm kind of upset about. I think that was like, that's gonna be like one of the best memories I'm gonna have with my dad. And he says he's gonna come back down for the next event, so hopefully we can get those pictures then. But we had a blast. Dad took 10 seconds off his time. I took damn near 9 seconds off my time. It was a great course, great first course for him. It was just a ball. So be looking out for that video, and hit the link down below if you want to get some of these parts. It's Not Stock. Sean, he's a great guy, great shop, great people. And
damn, I just can't get over how good this looks. I'm in love.
The only thing I have left that I want for the car is a trunk spoiler, which I've been thinking, I like how subtle this one is, and maybe just paint it black. I still want to black out the whatchamacallits, but for aesthetics, I mean, we're almost done. Trunk spoiler, still debating on putting the Racing Line emblem on over here.
They sent you guys, let me know what you think about that.
It's like a 50-50, and then the Racing Line stripe on the side whenever they send that, maybe, I don't know, we'll have to tape it up there and see how it looks. But the car is gorgeous.
I'm in love.
Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. We'll go for the next one, and I'll catch you on the flip-flop.